tables, they're the foundation of your database. If you spend time working with databases, you're going to be building lots of them. And just like in real life, they're where you store all your information. Over time, this will grow and grow and grow. This is my kitchen table. My parents bought it as a temporary solution when they moved house. 25 years ago, just like this, database tables can last a long time. And like real tables, they come in different varieties, each with different properties. Once you put your stuff on them, they're hard to move. So before you create one, it's worth spending a moment thinking about what type of table you want. By default, all tables in Oracle are heap organized. This means Oracle will store new rows wherever it can find space. Pretty much like when I add stuff to my tables. My wife likes things to be neat and organized. Instead of stuffing things wherever there's room, everything has to go in the correct place. I hate this because it makes more work for me when I'm trying to store things. But it does make it much easier to find things sorted together. An index organized table works exactly like this. All the rows have to go in the correct place according to the primary key. Next up, external tables. You use these to access non-database files. Personally, I like to sit at my external tables on a cool summer's evening, reading my files with a nice glass of wine. Often, you'll use these as a staging area before you load your data into your real tables. Temporary tables store data private to each session. No one else can see or access the information you add. Partitioning effectively splits your tables up into smaller tables. Rows are split among the partitions according to the partition key. These are perfect for when you have a dinner party with guests who hate each other. Tables will often store related information. This can lead to a lot of work if you have to fetch rows from two tables. Table clusters physically store related data together. This can make it much easier to find what you're looking for. So that was a quick overview of the types of table available in Oracle Database. We'll take a more detailed look at each of these in future episodes. Next up, we'll take a look at how you create the columns that make up the table. These are a key component of table design. So we'll take a quick rundown of the various types of columns available, including my favorite, Nelson's. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more about database development and see SQL magic.